There is a chance of congestion. There is a chance of, if you remember the congestion control, there is a chance of congestion also. So each packet contain a longer message split into series of packet, and each packet contains a portion of user data plus some control information. Okay, so what is the meaning of this header plus data as in your packet, or you can say that datagram? Okay, control information in this, you are mentioning some, you are doing some addressing or routing information. Addressing means there is a table. In table you maintain the entry, what is the source IP, what is the destination IP, and means that is your router, or you can say that the next hop. Okay, so you are maintaining the information like this. Packet are received and stored briefly, buffered, and pass on to the next node. It is store and forward technique. What is the meaning of this? Meaning of this is that I repeat once again, like maybe you get again remember. It is your source, it is your destination. Between source and destination, there is a path. Inside the path, there is no such dedicated path is mentioned here. So you are just give your packet to the first router R1, R2, R3. R4. Now R1 have three choice. Either it send this packet to this at this path, is this path and this path, or all at three path also. There is a possibility. But here the router one maintain the routing table. In the routing table, it maintain the entry of adjacent router. What is the adjacent router of R1? R2, R4, and R3. So now it know R1, R3, and R4. And now it know what is the best path and what is the shortest path. So just with the help of a routing algorithm, with the apply or it store the entry, it store the entry of a packet, and it forward to the best possible path. That is best shortest path, like this. It forward the packet to R4, and then R4 forward the packet to R3. There is no such kind of routing algorithm is there. There is no such kind of dedication path is there. So for finding the best possible path in the packet switching, it apply the routing. Routing information or routing algorithm, and every router maintain their own routing table. In routing table, there is entry, source, destination, and the next hop. Next hop or adjacent hop, you can say that. R2 also have their own routing table. R4 also, R3 also. Every router have their own routing table. Okay, so packets are received and stored. Stored briefly, or means packet are stored in buffer and passed to the next node or next hop. That's why it is known as a store and forward technique. Okay, as I already told you many times, the data, there are seven layers: application layer, presentation layer, session layer, network layer, transport layer, network layer, then your data link layer, then your physical layer. Okay, so always user interact with the application layer, always user give the data to the application layer. All remaining layer are working internally. User only interact with the application layer. So here, as you see in the figure, here user give the data. If data size is large, whatever you give here, data is breakdown into segments. If your segment is large, then you breaking down that segment into packets. If your packet size is large, then further you break down it into frames. So like that, you are working internally at a sender side, but at a receiver side, with this, everybody means every layer add their header plus data, every layer at sender side, they are adding the header, but at receiver side, they are removing the header. Please keep in mind. So user give the data to the application layer, and if your data is size is large, then you break down the data into different packets, because you are dealing with the network layer. So that's why you are talking about the packet. In a packet, there are two parts. One is your header, and other is your data. One is header, other data, header, data. So like that, you are breaking down this data into three different packet. Okay, after breaking down this, you just pass these packet to the over the network, and with the help of network, receiver get these packet. At receiver side, sender side, you are breaking down the packet, data into different packets. But at receiver side, you are reassemble the packets. Okay, it's your data, original data, and you are assembling this packet into the same data. Okay, so how they are assembling and all means how you identify this data packet is belong to the same data or not. For that purpose, we use the one identification field that we already discussed in IPv4 header, identification field. Or different field is used in the header portion. So by looking the header, the receiver can understand, okay, this data is belong to the, this packet is belong to the same data. Okay, next is your, this is all about your packet switching. Next is your virtual circuit and virtual circuit approach and your datagram approach. Switching technique is further divided into, packet switching is further divided into two portion. One is datagram and other is virtual circuit. As you see, the station break down the long message into packets, and the packet are sent one at a time onto the network. And packet switching is divided in two parts, datagram and virtual circuit. Okay, what do you understand by the datagram? Datagram, as we already see, there is a header part, 8-byte header is there that we already discussed in UDP. First of all, datagram is a unit of UDP, and segment is unit of TCP. Please keep in mind. Okay, so each packet is treated independently. Packet can packets can take any practical route. we will try to understand this line and how they take different route and all. So we will try to understand with the help of example in the upcoming slide. Okay, packet may arrive out of order. How they come out of order, how they reach out of order, that we will see in with the help of example in the diagram. Packet may go missing. There is a chance the packet may be missed or packet may be lost. Up to receiver reorder packets and recover from the missing packets means it's depend on the receiver. Receiver reorder that packet if your packet delivery is out of order, or they recover the missing packets. Okay, there is a sender and there is a receiver. The sender want to send 3-2-1 to the receiver. Okay, in a datagram how it travel, it can take the, again read the line, the packets packet can take any practical route, any route, please keep in mind, and packet may arrive out of order. These are two possibility. So there is the chance means 3-2-1. Okay, so three take the in the figure, two and one take this route, and three is now on the way. And after this node, the packet three take this route, and two take this route, and one is because we are sending like that. There are 2-1 and 2-1. First we send the one, then we send the two, and then we send the three. Okay, so like that it is working. That's why in figure number C, that one is delivered here. Okay, as you see in the fourth figure, the packet 3 travel this route. Okay, so it is reached here. The packet 2 and 1 follow this route. 2 and 1 follow this route. That's why they are reached here. But at this node, they meet and they again merge, and receiver get the original packet. Okay, so like this it can travel. Okay, what you understand by the virtual circuit? Virtual circuit means it is a pre-planned route established before any packet sent. What do you understand by this? The meaning of that is nothing else connection oriented. Means first you establish the connection, then you send the data, or you can say that it work on three-way handshaking. What is the meaning of this? First you establish the connection, then you transfer the data, and then you release the connection. Okay, so each packet contain virtual circuit identifier instead of destination address, and no routing decision is required here because dedicated path is there. Clear request to drop the circuit, and or you can say that release the circuit, dedicated path is there. Okay, let's try to understand with the help of example. As you see, before transmitting the data, I establish the path, dedicated path between sender to receiver, as you see on the screen. Okay, so after that, there are first I transfer the first packet number, then second, then third, like this. Okay, then I transfer the packet number 1, 2, and 3 on the same path, on the same path. No alternate path I followed, as you see. As you see in every figure, each packet follow the same route. Each packet follow the same route. Okay, so as you see on means what is the meaning of that? Resource are reserved here. Resource are reserved here, and you can say that a resource reservation. In resource, like your CPU is reserved and your bandwidth is dedicated, allocate. So like that, that is reserved. Okay, so one more thing is that I want to give the example, that is our phone call. Phone call going through the virtual circuit, and your data uses, whatever you are recharges, that is take the plan, either you take the Airtel, either you take the internet plan, data uses is your example of datagram. Please keep in mind. Okay. Let's try to understand the difference between these two. What is the difference between virtual circuit and datagram? Virtual circuit is a connection oriented, which means there is a reservation of resources like buffer, bandwidth, and your CPU is dedicatedly reserved for the time duration which the newly set up virtual circuit is going to be used by a data transfer session. So I think you get the idea. If anybody not able to understand, please type in chat box. Okay, it is a connection. Datagram is a connectionless service. It can be connectionless or it can be connection oriented, but mostly or by default it is connectionless. By default is it is connectionless datagram. Okay, there is no need for the reservation of resources, as there is no dedicated path between dedicated path for a connection session. What is the meaning of session? Until during the transmission of data, in that time there is no need of resource reservation, dedicatedly no need of dedicatedly allocate the resources. Guys, clear or not clear? Please reply.
Yes, ma'am, clear.
Okay, a virtual circuit use fixed path for a particular session, fixed path for a particular session, as I show you in the diagram, as I show you in the diagram, as you see. Okay, there is a dedicated path for a particular session until unless the data is not received by the receiver. Okay, so after which it break the connection, or you can say that it close the connection, and another path has to be set up for the next session. Please keep in mind what is the meaning of that. First, it is like that your non-persistence connection in HTTP. If you want to access 11 object, then you need 12 connection is there. 12 time you are establishing a connection. Okay, so like that you are establishing the connection, then you send the packet, then again release the connection, then new fresh connection is established, then other session is going on. Datagram based on network is a two packet switched network. There is no fixed path is allocated or no fixed path is there for transmitting the data. All the packets follow the same path. Please keep in mind, all the packets follow the same path, and hence global header is required. Means header is required. Only the first packet of connection and the other packet will not required. Means in one session, if you want to send five packet, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. During this session, no need to establish the connection again. Only one connection you establish for this five packet. If you want to transmit the data, means next one, that is 6 to 12, then you need one more connection. If you want to transmit the data 12 to 20, in that case you need another connection. Okay, so every packet is free in datagram. In that datagram, every packet is free to choose any path, and hence all the packet must be associated with the header containing information about the source and the upper layer data. Okay, packet reach in order. Always and always, please keep in mind, in virtual circuit or in circuit switching, in both switching, always packets reach in order. In order, never reach in out of order, because always they follow the same path to the destination as they follow the same path. But in the datagram, there is a chance that your data is received out of order, not reach in order. You can say that out of order. Virtual circuit is highly reliable, but your datagram circuit is not reliable that much as your virtual circuit is reliable. So costly, virtual circuit is costly, because each time new connection has to be set up with reservation, like you are reserving the resources. As you see here, means this node is dedicatedly allocated, this node is dedicatedly allocated in the virtual circuit. But as you see in the datagram, there is no node, there is no such node is dedicatedly allocated. So that's why your virtual circuit is costly, because every time it set up a new connection. It is your datagram is cost efficient, because no need of reserved resources. Okay, please keep in mind, switching at network layer in internet uses datagram approach to packet switching. Okay, our next topic is IPv6. IPv6 definition, advantage, header, and comparison between IPv4 and IPv6. Okay, then our routing is, then we will discuss the routing. And then we will discuss the routing algorithm one by one.